All right, guys. If you are watching this for the third time this evening, my stream kept failing in my shed. So I made this a Q&A session because I couldn't make it happen, but I felt bad for you guys because I didn't want to just leave you guys hanging. Sorry. So I made it into a Q&A session, and you guys can ask me whatever you want. So, like I said, I apologize for the shed out there. It was not cooperating. So hopefully, this will be much better, and you guys can ask me whatever you want, anything you want, and I will do my best to answer it as long as it's not too weird. But I had some really good stuff on the last live streams. I wasn't able to publish them because they were just, to be honest, it was too up and down and just wouldn't hold. So got rid of that. But some really, really cool things coming on the channel. If you guys have anything you want to ask me, type it right there on the screen, and I would love to start a conversation with you guys. I'm going to do this for like maybe 10, 15 minutes, and and just give me a... All right, here we go. Christopher Daniel says, woo, you're back. That's right. Christopher has tuned in like 3 times in a row. Aaron Hairston is, I think he threw a compliment my way in the first stream, but he says, hey, I'm going to think about getting a Glock 20. What do you think about a 10 mil? I think 10 mils are amazing. And I got to get some music for you guys, by the way. 10 mils are crazy good gun. That's one of the guns that I really want. And, I can't wait to take mine pig hunting when I finally get mine. Either that or a 45, probably a 10 mil, just because, you know, America. Because we can, but it's really cool. But anything that you guys want to ask me, shoot. Hello from Pennsylvania, love your videos. Thank you, Philip. I appreciate that, man. That is freaking... That's why I do it, because you guys are, like, so amazing. You guys have had such amazing impact on me in the past few years, and I deeply appreciate that. And one of the ways that I get back to you guys is in the comments field, the description field right below my little face. I've put a few of my discounts that you guys get. We get discounts from a company called Kenai Pro Gear on their bags and their tactical bags, their urban carry bags, their awesome bags. You get 15% off that. I've got gun cleaning stuff. I've got additional muzzle devices on the front from All Star Tactical. That's amazing. You guys get 10% off that. Then I've got unique ARs. Those are the really cool handguards in some of my other videos. You guys get free shipping on that, which is like 30 bucks. So awesome. What are your thoughts on JTS shotgun 12-gauge from Academy things? The Jackie Bear. I'm contemplating a 308 or a 7mm going back and forth. Any opinions? Excuse me. That's a good question. I would do a 308. And the reason that I would do a 308, not because it's so much better than a 7mm or anything like that. I think that the 308 is more versatile, so you're going to have more ammo options should you have to find ammo. It's going to be a lot easier to get a 308. It's going to, with military surplus being 308 cartridges, 7.62x51. I mean, you're going to be better off from a prepper standpoint, survivalist standpoint, and also just finding an ammo cheap. That's why I would do it. And on top of that, there's nothing really in North America that won't go down from a 308. Maybe a grizzly bear, but that's kind of the high end of the apex spectrum. So that's why I would not do that. But I would stick with the 308 just because of the versatility and the commonality of the round. But that was a good question, Philip. And one thing I want to tell you guys, which is amazing, the channel just broke 50,000 subscribers. So just under 2.5 years old, and we just broke 50,000, which is amazing. We're averaging around 2 million views a month, and that's all because of you guys. You guys are sharing the videos, you're talking about them, you're doing all these great things. And the more that you do that, the more that I can give you more cool stuff. Like a little really neat thing. I can give you behind the scenes a little bit. We're starting a series called, I can't say what it's called, but there will be Tannerite involved, and it will be weekly. So every single week, I'm going to put up one video involving Tannerite somehow, some way in that video. We'll have drones, we'll have trucks, we'll have barbecue, we'll have rednecks. And we'll have guns, of course. But it'll be amazing because we're in that really cool field that I always do my videos in. And we'll do some amazing stuff in there. Like, I cannot wait until these days to put these videos up. And it's going to have a set schedule. It's going to be each one day of a week. And it's going to be on a specific time. So you guys are the first to hear about that, which is really cool. And it'll be every single week there'll be something with Tannerite, which is awesome. Very, very awesome. And 50,000 subs, amazing. So, all because of you guys. But yeah, keep firing. Any questions you guys want to know about me? Anything you want to know a little bit about the guy behind the gun? Talk to me. Anything you want to know, I'll... Christopher Daniels says, can't wait, and he loves explosions. Well, then this is going to be a good vibe for you. I had the idea the other day of doing a Tannerite burrito. That sounds like a good idea, right? I wouldn't recommend eating it, but Tannerite burrito sounds a little epic. Getting rid of the split of bullet knife losers with Tannerite? What do you mean? Am I replacing the knife videos with Tannerite? Is that what you're asking me? Journey. And I'm at my computer, so I can pull stuff up. I can start pulling stuff up and think of cool ideas. So someone just asked me about knife videos. I didn't actually see the whole thing. Blowing up the actual knives? No, I'm not going to be blowing up the actual knives. That sounds like a terrible idea. Good Lord. Yeah, I can't see what was going wrong. Journey is cool. Aaron, you got that figured out. But yeah, so that's the kind of stuff that I'll be doing, and like Tannerite burritos. That's going to be exciting. It's not a good idea to do Tannerite knives, because then you got a knife like flying at you like a million miles an hour, which is not good. But that is what we've got coming up. If there's anything that you guys would like to see specifically, like anything kind of out of the box, I'd love to hear your opinions right now, because this is like you're talking directly to me. This is live. As of 11 p.m. Eastern time, this is completely live, so you guys can do whatever you want and tell me what it is. Saw a Tannerite Twinkie Tower. A Twinkie Tower. I might just do that, because that's a good idea. A Twinkie Tower. I love that. Where's my notes? I'm putting that in there. That's a good one. I don't even care if it's somebody else's. Christopher Daniel says, well, I always shoot a XD. Why not a Glock? The reason that I don't shoot a Glock a lot is because I had a Glock and it got stolen, which it made me sad. Aaron Hairston asked me, or he says, I'm in the minority. I love a Taurus firearm. What are your opinions? Honestly, Taurus is good, like halfway down the middle. Semi-automatics, not in love with them. The revolvers, definitely will handle those. Those are very, very good. All right, Neptune Blues says, hello from Switzerland. Great channel, by the way. Have you had the opportunity to shoot the BNT APC-9? I have not. I have not. I've heard myth and lore about that, but I have not actually had the opportunity. But I will definitely look into that. What am I trying to do here? I think I'm doing this. I think someone just said do a Tannerite Yeti, which I'm like, what? Gave my daughter a Bodyguard 380. She has mentioned getting a Sky. I would stay away from that, and I would stay with the Bodyguard. Personal experience. The Skies are kind of like a cheap version of a Glock and a Kel-Tec, and like they had a weird cheap baby. And it's not a fantastic gun. And you know, they are cheap, but I would just spend the money and keep the Bodyguard or get the Smith & Wesson Shield. I'm just saying, like, that's what I would do. And Ghost Tactical said, thanks, me too, just wanted to make sure. But yeah, the Skies, the SCCYs, those semi-automatics, it's kind of like a Glock clone, but it's very strange. It's double-action Glock clone kind of deal, and it has a Kel-Tec-style flat hammer, which is very strange, and personally, no way. I fired them a few times. I own the M85, love the 38 Special, plus P, I'm old school. Aaron says he's old school. Ghost Tactical says, I carry the Shield every day and love it. That's a good call. The Shield's a great gun. Philip says, do you feel the ports on the 45s truly make a difference, both Shields? You're not going to notice the huge difference on the ports on the 45. You're going to notice a huge difference with the ports on a 9mm or a 40. I don't even think they make it in a 40. But you're going to notice it in the 9mm because it's a higher pressure round, and the pressure is going to come out those ports and hold the gun a little flatter. 45 being a low pressure round is going to help you a lot more, or a lot less on the porting. Dave says, many people in the gun community say plus P is okay. Others say it's not approved. It's not SAMI approved. What do you think? Plus P plus is kind of stupid. The only people that I've ever seen use plus P plus ammunition are 9mm fanatics, and they're the guys that will come into a range and say 9mm will beat any kind of round possible, and it doesn't matter because 9mm. And I have nothing wrong with 9mm, but the people who will do a plus P plus, you're basically increasing the pressure in that gun twice to accommodate even more pressure, which equals more velocity, and they're thinking that it's actually going to, you know, make a huge difference over a 40 cal or a 45 or whatever. Personally, I wouldn't shoot plus P plus just because that's just, I mean, what's the point? People will say, oh, it's terrible because a 40 cal will pop a real bad. Well, if you do 9mm plus P plus, it's going to pop just as bad. So, I mean, that's my own personal belief. All right, we are at the 10-minute mark, and I'm going to cut this feed at 15 minutes. So we have about 4 minutes. But I just want to say thank you to you guys because you guys have made this channel a really great experience. You've made it 50,000 subscribers, 2 million views a month, and so many great things are coming down the pipe for you guys that are directly from you just watching the videos, which I hope, and I'm getting amazing feedback that you say you're liking, which is awesome. What song is this? Let's find what song this is. Ooh, Bon Jovi, Living on a Prayer. 10mm, is it worth having for range and home? No, it's not. 10mm is one of the most powerful semi-automatic cartridges available, and I personally would not use it for home because it's going to penetrate way, way more than you want it to. Go through walls, go through all sorts of stuff, and for range, it's expensive ammo, and I wouldn't waste it on a range. If you're going to do anything like a 10mm, just do a 40 cal, which is a 10mm shorter. So, I mean, that's what I would do if you're going to go that style, but personally, I don't like the idea of a 10mm in a home defense situation simply because it's over penetration and overpower. Now, if you're talking about hunting hogs or hunting deer, I'd do a 10mm, but I wouldn't do it for home defense. But good question. Excellent question. But yeah, 50,000 subs, guys. I can't believe it. It's been 2.5 years. I've had 2 kids since then. All right, Ghost Tactical says, looking to upgrade trigger on Glock 19, any thoughts on the best aftermarket? Ghost triggers are amazing. They're very good. Obviously, the Zev upgrades are very good as well, but the Ghost triggers are... The Ghost Kits, I think they're called. They're amazing. They're really, really good. But that's the thing about Glocks that I don't really understand. People love Glocks because they're the best guns on the market, but then they spend so much money, which makes it even more expensive. But it does, I mean, it kind of brings it up or above the other guns. So, you know, it's kind of like an AR-15, sorry. Mail the Nuts says, good answer, would rather hunt with a 30-30. Yeah, hunting with a 30-30 is awesome, especially if you're on the East Coast, because the East Coast is so brushy and there's not a lot of open space in deer country. Not like out west. Now, out west, you need like a 30-06, a 308, 7 mils, you know, all those different amazing calibers that will really reach out a long way. But, yeah, 30-30 in the East is awesome. And I have a 300 blackout for my hunting needs in the East. And I know people hate the 300 blackout, and I don't get it. I love it, but just me. I think it's going to come. I think it's going to get a lot of steam in the next few years. I think people are getting a lot of crap they don't need to. Ghost Tactical says, "Is it worth changing out or leave a factory?" I would leave a Glock trigger in the factory. Melvinut says, "30-30 is good in Wisconsin too." That's true. Edwin, what's your take on the PT-111? Is it a good EDC? It's not a bad EDC. I'm not going to say it's a bad one. You're talking about pretty decent gun, PT-111. Yeah, I'd say it's not a bad gun. It's a little larger than I'd want it, but not bad. That was a lot of comments like real quick. Christopher Daniels. Yep, I live in New England and hunt either with a 30-06 or 308. Nice. I'm also I have a 30-06, a 308, and a 300 blackout, which I'm hoping I can get an animal on all three of those calibers this year, which would be amazing, and I would film it for you guys and show what's going on now. Out with a 300 blackout, I'll do a lot of deer and hog with 300 blackout. I'll definitely do a 30-06 with deer, and I'll do a 308 with both, probably. I kind of want to see what happens when I shoot a pig with a 308. and then compare it for a 30-06 and a 300 blackout. But lots of really cool stuff. Also, I can tell you this, guys, next year we are going to, and I say we, I mean you and I, we are going to Argentina, potentially New Mexico, Texas, Alaska. We've been invited to South Africa. Mel says instant sausage. Christopher says have 300 blackout AR-15. Haven't hunted it though. Oh, I'm definitely hunting my 300 blackout this year. But all these things, we're going hunting in these different locations across the globe because you guys watch this channel. How freaking cool is that? Because you guys watch me just shoot stuff. Mason Pearson Persons says, can I have a shout out? Yes, you can, because you're watching and because you have an American flag as your emblem. So all of these things are really awesome, and we get to go to these cool countries and hunt pigs and hunt dove and hunt all these things and then help the people in that area by giving them the food. So it's kind of like a nonprofit meets Second Amendment meets America meets like give here, eat, which I'm really excited about, and I get to take you guys with me, and I'm so amped because I couldn't do this without you guys. It's just amazing. And we've got all sorts of sponsors that we're negotiating with and talking about simply because you watch the videos. And if you guys keep watching those videos and sharing them out and liking them and passing them along, that's how this happens. And it's so cool. It's so amazing the way this happens. The power in social media is amazing. And the gun world, especially, is very, very loyal, which is so cool. I like this song a lot. Is that weird? Skid Row. Mason Person says, I am 12 and I hunt with a 7mm 08. Wow. 12 years old and hunting and with a 7mm? What are you hunting, dude? Are you hunting like moose? You hunting moosin'? 7mm is a big freaking round. That thing's gonna put some whatever you're hunting down pretty quick. So Mason, what are you hunting with a 7mm? I'm really curious. Whitetail? Okay, so Mason says he's hunting whitetail with a 7mm. I'd love to hear what you guys think about that, because 7mm is going to kind of like leave nothing left of that deer. And that's kind of why I will hunt with like a 308 or 30-06, just because it doesn't have the velocity of 7mm does. Whew, that's a big round. That's kind of like hunting a deer with a 300 Win Mag. You're not going to have a whole lot left. Which is messed up. Oh, man. Exactly. Ghost Tactical says, I hope he doesn't want the meat. Carl Pylord says, sometimes I dress up on my dog in my sister's clothes and pretend it's my sister when I and dose this dog with something. That was a lot. I don't know where to go with that. That's the kind of comment that's crazy. Yeah, but 7mm still, I know it's not a Remington mag. So Mason says 7mm 08, not 7mm Remington mag. True, but they're still very, very powerful. Christopher Daniels says, yeah, but he's 12. If he misses a little bit, probably still going to kill it. That is true. But I'm not going to take away from my man Mason here, because my name was almost Mason, and then it wasn't. No, I almost named one of my kids Mason, because I like that name. But I don't know, 7mm, hey, you do you. You can always size up to a moose or an elk, go out to Colorado or something. Pretty freaking cool. I love hearing stories like 12-year-olds or younger kids getting into the gun industry, and it's awesome. John Rann, this is a buddy I've known for years, says, wife needs a new purse gun, 9mm MP shield. Yes, that's exactly what I would do, John. Mason Persons, shoot it in the neck, it jumps up and drops. Shoot it in the neck. Jeez, how much do you hunt, Mason? Shit. Hit it right in the jugular, the neck just blows off. I guess you save the meat that way. That's crazy. Ghost Tactical says, wow. John Rann says, Mason is my hero. Mason, you're getting popular here. All right, Redneck RC says, what do you think is the best gun for self-defense in your opinion? Depends where you are, what your laws are, and what you can do and what you can handle. Shotguns are an amazing option. I would recommend highly looking at the 9mm versus 12-gauge versus AR-15 video series that I put up. That kind of gives you a perspective of the different power that you're playing with. Mason got all excited that everyone likes him. James Johnson, do you think the... come on, James. I'm not going to do political. Redneck says a handgun. Cy Garcia says, hey, buddy, I have a good question. 870 Mariner or 5... No. I'd do an 870, which I would do, because that's a little bit more oomph to it. I like the steel internals rather than the polymer. But Redneck RC asked handgun. He specified what's the best handgun for self-defense. 9mm are all... You can't go wrong with a 9mm. 45 is even more power, but a lot less ammo, so it's kind of like a give and take. And I'm going to give you guys a 30-second warning, because I don't want these live sessions to go too long, because I know they can really drool on. James Johnson says, McGregor or Mayweather? Mayweather. I don't know. The first one. Mason, I missed what you just said. Sorry, bro. But yeah, guys, I'll give you one more. I'll give it another minute. Redneck RC says, I've got a 40 M&P shield. You switch a Smith & Wesson. I like that gun a lot. It's a great one. I saw an Anderson AM-15 at Cabela's. Anderson AR-15 is okay. Lonzo Ball, Rookie of the Year or bust. Honestly, I don't know. I don't have time to watch sports. Sorry. Mason Persons wants a shout-out in one of my vids. Well, this is going on my channel, so you can have a shout-out here, Mason. Mason's awesome. James Johnson, what's one thing that surprises people the most when you tell them about yourself? That I am a father of 3 toddlers under 4, and that I am a firearms instructor, and I have my own business. And a lot. And I'm working on my master's degree. There's a whole lot going on. The Cy Garcia says, Colt 6940 for my first AR-15. It's not a bad start. Colts are very reliable guns. I mean, they're nothing like extremely fancy, like a Daniel Defense or anything, but they are good guns. James, you're killing me, man. James says, what do I think about people that think the earth is flat? No comment. Christopher Daniels says, what am I mastering in? I am mastering in economics and probably have a BS in marketing. James, come on now. Don't troll the system. You know better than that, James. Oh, man, these live videos are so much fun. It's stupid. It's ridiculous. Mason Persons, lots of guns showing up in his emojis. Okay. Mason, what part of the country do you live in? Like, what state? James. I'm not going to badmouth people. Mason lives in VT, Vermont, huh? Not bad, man. In a, like, very hostile environment. You're holding strong. I like that. Oh, James Johnson, you silly wabbit. I put him in timeout. I don't know what that means. That's funny. By the way, I'm going to meet the Marine Corps soon. Aside, that's freaking awesome. Redneck RC, he's in Virginia. That's great. Edwin, can you do more of the 40, 45, and 9mm test? I enjoy watching it. Yes, I will. That's definitely coming. John Rand, best manufacturer for ARs. Pretty much anybody. They're all military spec. Christopher says Mason should spit. Mason should, oh, hell yeah, Ghost. Ghost is a Semper Fi. Hell yeah, he's a Marine. I would go with either, I mean, Daniel Defense is the high end. You could go with a Springfield entry level. You could go, but people don't like them right now. You could go with Rock River Arms. People also don't like them right now. There's a lot of things people don't like right now. But there's a lot of good guns. Smith & Wesson has an M&P-15, which is good. Aaron Hairston, Delaware is very tough. We need more Second Amendment supporters here. Yes, you do. Mason wants to join the Corps. Sweet. That's right. That's what I'm talking about. Badly. Well, ooh, Van Halen just came on. Have you shot Demo Ranches R1T? Have you shot Demo Ranches R1T? I don't know what that means, Redneck. Oh, AR-15. Oh, yeah. I've never shot that skeleton AR-15 on Demolition Ranch. Christopher Dance, 6 more. Yes, bud. Mel the Nut. PSA sells whole ARs. Palmetto State Armory is a good spot for an AR. That's awesome. Yeah, John, you could do Palmetto State. Matt from Demo Ranch is one of my, like, one of my bros. I don't really know him, but I'm like, I will know you one day. My people will get you to your level. Give me your level. Oh, this is really cool. I can tell you guys this. So I will be on TV, national TV, next month in August. One of my videos got chosen for a show called Outrageous Acts of Science, and it's actually being analyzed by like physicists and all these really smart people to tell you exactly what's happening in the video. So that's freaking cool. You guys made that video popular, and then they liked it, and they were like, hey, can we put this on TV? And I was like, sure. So that's amazing. Very, very exciting. So amped. It's going to be so much fun. And hopefully they'll give a really good growth to the channel as well and kind of pile on and just keep it going, which is what we really want. BO3 Beast, did you hear that gun and ammo prices have decreased? Yes, I did. Redneck RC, so did Matt from the Ranch. Aaron Harrison, congrats. Thanks, man. That's awesome. I appreciate that. It is badass. I'm excited. It's very badass. So I'm hoping that'll make a really big splash on the channel. Which I think it will.
Redneck RC, that's actually an interesting point. It's not because of Trump that the guns and the ammo prices are coming down. I was involved with a lot of people right before that election occurred, and what was happening, and is a little bit inside baseball on the gun stuff, companies like Springfield, like Glock, SIG, all of these companies had really thought that Hillary Clinton was going to win, and so they pre-ordered all the guns, and they pre-ordered all the manufacturing. They brought their production forward right before the election. They got it all in, and when Trump won, there was all of a sudden this glut of ammo and of inventory that they needed to get rid of, and because of that, that's why you're seeing the prices come down. Also, the gun industry, like the consumers side of it, took a big sigh of relief after like 8 years of being on the ropes, and we're like, ah, we'll get it later. So that's why the prices are going down. Mason says, I hope you have fun making vids, stay safe, and do more live streams like this. I'm going to try to, Mason. I'm trying to dance that fine line. BO3 Beast, what do you think about building an AR? It's the best thing ever. It is the best thing ever. I love building ARs. John Rand, except for Pepper, is sad. That is true. Ghost Tactical, will the industry adjust itself? Hope not. I don't think so. Where's the best place to buy ammo online? Don't mess in the economist. That's right, Mel. Mel says don't mess in the economist. I love economics. Economics and marketing. It's kind of a weird thing. A really good place to buy ammo online. Ammo Seek is a good one. Christopher Daniels just said that. Mason, I only have a shotgun once. They're all right. Birthday next month's getting an AR and a 10 mil. Ooh, that's a good birthday, Aaron. AR and a 10 mil? Hell yeah. Mel the Nut, Freedom Munitions is also a great place to get ammo. One place that I like a lot is LAX Ammo. They make really good ammo. BO3 Beast asks, what about Midway? Mel the Nut says, Target Sports UDA. Redneck says, yeah, I heard once Obama said something stupid. The gun shows made more money from preppers and hardcore gun enthusiasts. Lucky Gunner for ammo. LAX is good. Yeah, so Mason ARs are amazing. I'm having trouble keeping up in the comments. So a good spot for ammo is LAX. They're really good. AIM Surplus also has pretty good pricing on theirs. There is AmmoSeek.com where you can kind of sort out exactly what you want. It shows you the cheapest prices on the net. It's like a bot. Gunbot.net is also a good place to do that, so it's really cool. And guys, I'm actually getting more people in here, so I'm going to keep the stream going because it's actually increasing, which I'm not going to complain about. Go ahead. So, Sai says, thanks, guys. And Mason says, laggy. Laggy, I'm like on freaking home Wi-Fi. I wish I could have had you guys out there cleaning my AR with me like I planned. That was a lot more like gun world, instead of just looking at this mug. Oh, God. That was a lot of comments, guys. I dig it. I love it. BO3 Beast asks what state I live in. I live in Georgia. Mel the Nut, Target Sports USA is good if you can afford to buy bulk. Also true. Mason says 14 are watching. I've actually got 19 are watching right now, which I'm down with. Oh man, it's so cool. I love live streaming. It's the coolest thing. Pighead, yeah. 308 or 556, you have been a subscriber for a while. I remember seeing your comments a long time ago. Thank you for that. Mel the Nut, garage Wi-Fi was not good. Mason, nice, because you can keep up with the comments. That's true. If it gets much faster, I'm not going to be able to keep up with all the comments. But yeah, a minute ago, I was actually in my work shed 100 feet behind my house, and it was not working out. I tried like 3 live streams. It didn't work out. Justin Hommick says, or Hornick, excuse me, 357 mag or 9mm? I do 9mm because it's a semi-automatic. You can get more of them. Christopher Daniels, are you anywhere close to IV-88? I am. Yes, I am. Clover Tack, Langley Firearms Academy, fairly new sub here. Thank you. Thank you for subbing, man. Tell your friends. Get some more people in here. I love that. Thank you. Ricky Mohan, more 30-06 vids, please. People are forgetting about what started it all. BO3 Beast, is there really a ban on Vepers? Kind of. It's specific ones, but yeah. Meldenut, am I doing Patreon? I'm not yet. It's actually an interesting question. Do you guys think I should do Patreon? Mason is definitely one of my heroes, at least for the next hour. But if you guys think I should do Patreon, I will gladly do so. But I just haven't done it because I didn't want to do the I didn't want to go through the whole hey give me money because you know I make videos. I just I don't know. I didn't want to do that. We need to build this channel. We do. You are right. Mason's all excited. So one of the cool things that I'm putting together for you guys, like I said, the way that I give you back, the only way that I can give each of you things back is when I do cool deals. I'm in for a buck on Patreon. Sweet. Thank you. That's awesome, Mel. I'll see what I can do for you on that. And, you know, it's like a buck a month. That'd be kind of cool. 50,000 subscribers did that. It's a whole lot of money. Patreon. What is Patreon? Patreon is a site where you can say, hey, I'll give this person a buck a month if they put up videos. Okay, I'm losing these people. What would you recommend for my first AR-15? I just want to get the basics down and learn how to shoot it. Eventually, I'll do my own build. I like Smith & Wesson. Those are good guns. M&P-15s. It's definitely copywritten music, but all I'm doing is listening to it, so it's like in the background. It's not like I put it in the video. Works for Yankee Marshall. Yes, it does. The Patreon stuff is really good. I mean, if you can get a good amount of people, you can really build something special there. My main thing is I want you guys to tell your friends about it, and I want to give you stuff for free. I will definitely put up a Patreon. He quit doing fun videos. Yeah, I'm just getting started on the fun videos. I've got the audience now, so I've got like 50,000 subs, and each video gets around 5,000 views instantly. Like, probably not instantly, but like in the first 48 hours. So YouTube will start sending that out and kicking it, which is awesome. And so now I'm going to start doing some fun videos. We got Tannerite stuff coming up every week. Redneck RC says, do giveaways. That's a fantastic idea. My wife says the exact same thing, and I should. BO3B says, I'm still upset there's no more respect for police. I would agree, that's stupid. Jordan Johnson digs it. Ghost Tactical, just starting my channel. Any suggestions to help grow? Content is king. If you're not good at video, be good at content. I will talk about guns now. Mason, okay. If you are starting a channel, I would recommend to have great content. YouTube creators don't build a channel with Patreon, but rather with creating good content. That's correct, right. So that's very true. So I try to put up a video multiple times a week, and it's hard, but it's gotten me to the point where I am, and I'm going to continue doing that probably for another year or two, and then I'll slow down a little bit. I'll probably incorporate more live videos with some really cool stuff, like I said earlier in the stream. Melvin Nutt says I should join on Yankees chats and NEAs, which is not a bad idea. But next year, I'm going to go to like Argentina, Mexico. I told you guys earlier in this thread, if you're new, I'm going to go to all these countries and hunt because you guys watch the channel, which is pretty cool. Ivy8888, I've actually met him, and I met him when I didn't have a gun channel. Do an RC truck that has a servo shooting at 22LR and a thing of fire. Wow. Yeah, I'm working on collaborations with other channels. Yeah, I've actually met Ivy8888 and Eric. And pretty cool dude. I met him when he had 400,000 subscribers, and I was at a shoot with him, and I started helping him with some stuff. For starting a starting channel, be driven. Braden's the hardest working guy I know. That is John Rand. I know him personally. Thanks, John. A flamethrower. I can't get the level yet. Well, Redneck, I'm bringing Tannerite every single week, and it's always going to be unique. Chuck Middleton, me and Such. I want to catch Such. I got a target on him. I want to catch him in the channel. Visit Europe. I'm not sure I'd go over well. Am I going to collaborate with Demo Ranch? I don't think I'm big enough to collaborate with Demo Ranch yet. I really would love to, but I'm not there yet. One day I will. I will catch it. I will catch him eventually, or at least come close. But Matt is an awesome, awesome YouTube person. YouTube personality. Where can you get Tannerite? In Georgia, like anywhere. You can order it online. You can walk into a store. CloverTac makes his own Tannerite. Bigger boom and more smoke. Neptune, is that an invitation to Switzerland? That is my wife who wants to go to Switzerland, apparently. Every explosion is going to be worth like a couple thousand subs. I think it's going to be worth more than that. Those are going to be some fun videos. I'm going to do some really fun things on those videos. Like, I'm just excited. buy an RC truck and have a person drive it and shoot it at the same time. That's a good idea. like your bullet caliber description comparison videos. 380 versus 9mm difference. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, there's lots of fun stuff coming up. The RC one's a good idea. I'm going to write that one down. Man, keep up with some of these articles sometimes. It's kind of like, oh, man. Freaking awesome. Let's go all the way down here. With a flamethrower. I can't get a flamethrower yet. Should I build an AR? I'm really thinking about it. Yes. And the reason I say that, if you build an AR, you will never go back. Ever. It's the best thing ever. I know how to make napalm. Yeah, so do I, RC. That's easy. But if you make your own AR, you get into it and you understand how it works and you really get it. Yama Dave says, hey dude, what's up Yama? Build an AR. You'll learn about it, how it works. Love the explanation, the explanatory vids, man. Thank you. Thank you, Jordan. That's awesome. I really try to make some good content and I'm glad you like it. What was I going to do? Oh yeah, Tannerite Burrito. How do you spell burrito? RC car with Tannerite on it. That's a good one. Once you build your AR. Thank you, Aaron. Thank you for stopping by. Once you go with an AR and you build it, you'll never buy an AR-15 again, ever. My personal carry load for defense is critical duty. Neptune from Switzerland says, absolutely, we have tons of cool guns here. Neptune, that's my wife. If you keep this road, I'm going to end up in Switzerland. AR equals big kid Legos. 100% agree. I wouldn't mind going to Switzerland. That's kind of cool. Although you got that whole like Muslim thing taken over kind of deal, and I'm kind of like, ah. I'd like to see more reloading videos. Now, that's not a request I get a lot. Chuck Middleton just got a Timney trigger. It rocks. Awesome. And Chuck, you've been a subscriber for a while. I recognize your name and your avatar. Thank you. I love doing these live feeds and everything. It's really, really cool. And I love interacting with you guys. It's so much fun. And watching when I put a video out and watching it just kind of take off is just great. So freaking fantastic. Actually, car with Tannerite glued to it. Taped it. Yeah. BO3B says, I enjoy XDs as well, Braden. That's good, because I like that gun a lot. Even though Springfield did get it when I'm angry at him. Live shows are awesome. I agree. Thank you, Clover. See, I'm trying to get good at these. Bravo Blue Spino me. I don't know what that means, but I'm not getting into that. Did I vote Trump? I am not going to disclose that on the interwebs, because it's my personal business. Mwah, mwah, mwah. I will tell you I'm more libertarian-leaning, though. Psych Garcia, what do you think of Smith & Wesson MP 2.0? I was actually just looking that up last night. That's a really good one. Ghost Tactical, have you shot the P320? It looks amazing. I'm thinking about getting one. I have shot the P320. It's very strange to shoot a SIG without a hammer. Be honest. They are good guns. They feel kind of like a fancy Glock. It's kind of like a fancy Glock. It's not bad at all. Future review. Like what's coming up? I don't have any reviews right this second. Actually, I have one coming up. Neptune from Switzerland says, we keep Muslims in check here. We're not French frogs. Okay. Steve, have you ever argued with a liberal about gun control in real life, or is that not your thing? That is my thing. I don't actually argue. I just kind of calmly talk about it. Love my P320. I have the full 9mm. Nice. Christopher Daniels, haha. Clover Tag is giving me $5. Cool. Thank you, Clover. That's amazing. I think he gave me $5. I'm pretty sure he tipped me $5. That's cool. I didn't know you could do that. Like I said, I'm pretty new to this. I appreciate that. That's awesome. But, do you guys like the pig videos? What are your thoughts on Glock not getting the military contract? That's military. I mean, you know, they choose what they want and who wants what. You know. SIG. I don't know if the SIG was cheaper. I don't know. SIGs are pretty expensive, and Glocks are pretty dirt cheap. But I do think it's interesting to change, though. What was your secret on getting 50,000 subs? That's a freaking lot of people. Hard-ass work. I busted my butt to get to that point, and it's all because I had the support of you guys. It's not like I did anything super amazing. What time did I hit that button? Ooh, let's hit that one. Cool. Now I gotta go back. There we go. Shoot a propane tank like they did on Mythbusters. I could do that. That'd be fun. SIG was $100 million cheaper on the contract. See, I didn't know that, Mel. The SIG P226 Legion is an awesome gun. Yes, it is. That is an amazing gun. I really like that gun. It's really stupid, though. Really, SIG's bid was way cheaper. Cool. See, I didn't even know they were way cheaper. 50K is awesome. You were recommended to me by several different folks, none of which are here right now. That's okay. Have you experienced Social Justice Warriors? I missed that one. I'm sorry. I'm trying to keep up. It's hard. Remember, I said I was going to stop this video at, oh God, like 20 minutes. It's like 40 minutes in. I just like talking to you guys. This is fun. All right. So I've got Tannerite Burrito. I've got RC car with Tannerite tape to it. It's pretty good. How about Tannerite Pumpkin? It's kind of overdone, but. I was going to tell you guys something else. I was telling you a story about Eric from IV8888. I was actually there when he did a lot of... I'll do this live feed all night long. I'm on Wi-Fi. I don't care. I did an interesting thing. I was actually at a big range shoot, the first range shoot that they ever did, and I met him the day before. He had 400,000 subs, and he had 1 million views a month. That was his things. Art with Tannerite and paint. That's a good idea. Trick shot that ends off mini propane. Oh, shoot the end off mini propane tanks. That's a cool idea. Tannerite in a thing of ethanol. Wow, it's getting violent. I love it. That thing will blow like crazy. See how far the propane tanks will travel when you shoot the end off. That's an interesting idea. A little competition. Christopher Daniel, that works very well with nearly empty spray paint cans. It's really stupid. How many subs did you get before the YouTube Manager Network contacted you? I was contacted pretty early, around 12,000 to around 15,000. But that's because my view counts were extremely high. My ratio of views is very, very high for my subs, and that's why they contacted me. Ghost, loving the live feed. Seems like it'll get more people to know your personality. Great job. Thank you. That's actually why I'm doing this. So I appreciate that. I'm glad you could see that. That's awesome. You guys see the bug flying around here? Yeah, here. I appreciate that, because that's what I'm trying to do. Propane tanks with incendiary rounds. You guys want me to die, don't you? You should make some t-shirts with your logo for your viewers. Awesome. Awesome. I should definitely do that. I actually just secured a deal with Grunt Style. What advice would you give to YouTubers trying to grow and sign with YouTube networks? Did you sign with the first one, or did you? I will not sign with one. Do you sub to NRA? Yes, I do. I only have 3 guns. No, that's okay. You're only 12. You got like one for every 4 years of your life, and the first one you couldn't even touch. Stop moving. Stop. Stupid phone. We just want entertainment and to make you money. Well, thank you. Actually, guys, I will tell you this. If you guys are starting a channel, or you have a channel, or you're thinking about starting a channel, send me an email. I'll do that. Send me an email. Stay independent, yes. If you guys have a channel, you have questions about multi-channel networks like he's talking about, or if you want to get work with me on some stuff, I'll tell you what. Yeah, do that. The email is live@langleyfirearmsacademy.com. That's live@langleyfirearmsacademy.com. I will answer back. So I got some things coming up that you might be interested in. So if you want to talk, we can talk. I do have the Twitters. It's @LangleyFirearms. But yeah, if you guys want to send me an email, shoot it to me. Just say, hey, I'm Ghost from the live feed, or hey, I'm whoever from the live feed, and I'll do that. And that's what I'll do. I will respond back, because I've got a really unique, kind of outside-the-box idea. Do you DM on... I can DM on Twitter. You should get on gun channels, too. Yes, I should. I should. Jordan Johnson says, definitely saying sub. Thanks for looking forward to more. Thank you. That's awesome. Ricky Mohan, he's new. What is your ideal hunting rifle with what caliber? I would do a 30-06 or a 308 or a 300 blackout. My Instagram is @LangleyFirearms as well. Mason, say you're the 12-year-old hunter. I'll remember you. Full 30 I could get in. But I need to know more details on that. I know the people who started it. Yeah, 30 caliber is my favorite caliber across the board. I know the people who started it, and I know what their kind of model is. That's got to be right. You're an entrepreneur, so you probably aren't a dumb little teenager who signs with networks, so you probably have a better business mindset and see through the YouTube. Yeah. Honestly, the stay humble, that's most guys' mistake. Can't stand know-it-all. Yeah. My first gun was an AR-15. No, my first gun was a Smith & Wesson SDV. SDV, I can't remember. 40. SDV 40. SDVE 40. Terrible gun. But it was a good one. My second gun was an AR-15. I would not get a Nova, no. But I'll tell you, the YouTube thing and staying humble is important. It's huge. That's one of the reasons that I'm doing all these things that, like the giving back kind of deal. Interesting first gun. How old are you? I'm 31. I just turned 31. Yep, 31. Working on a master's degree. Got lots of little kids. Seen the Tannerite refrigerator video. Be careful. Yeah, don't worry. I'm good with that. Did you ever collaborate with anyone to get more exposure? I have not yet. Not quite yet. I've got some things that I've been putting together, but not yet. SDVE, cheap gun. Yes, it is, John. Thank you. That's why we like you, because you're humble. Thank you, Chuck. I appreciate that. You should get a Ford Raptor like Matt on Demo Rant. I'll tell you what. If the things that I'm working on right now involving YouTube and some of the partnerships and the collaborations come together, then I will absolutely get a Raptor like Matt. Or after, I'll probably get something different. I don't know what I'll get. But I will get a truck, and I'll pour it all back into the business because it's so much fun. It's amazing. That email is live@langleyfirearmsacademy.com. Ford Raptor is a waste of money. I'm staying out of the Ford and Chevy debate. Just saying. The media needs to grow up and show more concealed and carry cases. I agree. Hey, what should I get? I know the Nova is a heavy gun. It's definitely a heavy gun. Chevy. Someone just followed me on Instagram. Good luck on your MD. What are you majoring in? Economics. What car truck do you have? I have a Ford Sports Track. If I wanted to get a precision competition rifle, what would you recommend? Oh my God, I'm losing it. A Tika is amazing if you can have like $3,000 laying around. The email is live@langleyfirearmsacademy.com. When you guys hit all those comments at the exact same time, I'm like, oh, mother of God. I get all excited because YouTube will push it out and it'll start fading and I'm like, no. And I try to read it and my wife knows I can't read incredibly fast. My wife can like speed read an entire page in like 10 seconds. And I'm like, okay, I read words. And I'm just, you know, I'm normal. Well, that's crazy. Awesome. But insane fast reader. But yeah, Matt at Demo Ranch is one of my guys I want to try to get to that level. How much training do you recommend for your concealed carry weapon? I would do at least 50 rounds every 2 weeks. Nice music in the background. I grew up in the 80s. That's because this is amazing. The Beatles or on the radio? I said the Beatles. This is Journey. Dum. Dum, dum, dum. Got this real cool little patch. Rainier Arms. Like when you go to these places, it's awesome. My dad has a Dodge and he's 10 years old, still works and looks great. That's not a gun. I can't do anything with that. You guys want to see what I'm working on? I know nothing about guns. Okay. The first series I watched was 9 versus 40 versus 45. Thank you. 357 or 9mm for home defense. I would do a 9mm because it's easier recoil and it's easier to follow up. No, that's cool. I don't know why. Do you know if there are any conversion kits for Glock Gap? I do not. I don't think that there is. I was not in the military. And this is, by the way, is my next series coming up if I can ever get out there and not rain. But these are my next comparisons. G2 stuff. Really cool. Got pig heads, we got wood, we got walls, we got things for days. I do always think it's funny though when people tell me I don't know anything about guns, like the person just did in the comments. I think it's interesting. My dad has a 01 Ford. Yeah, it's because it's a diesel. Diesels are amazing. No, it's live. Alex, like, this is legit. Like, Alex at 11:42. It is 11:42 p.m. on the Eastern Time. This is live. So now when the video is replaying, it's not live, obviously, because it just stays up forever. But right now, it's live. What kind of training do you offer? I do mostly intro classes. Sitting in my home in South Dakota, that's really cool. I do intro classes because I find that that's a lot more realistic. I don't like training people to be tactical warriors in their house. I want people to be comfortable, confident, and effective. I'm not going to teach somebody, you know, how to engage multiple targets, reload real fast, you know, grab a baby while you're doing this like IDPA does. I just don't think that's practical. That's not my personality. That's not my style. CloverTac trains youth. Awesome. Everyone should. Jonathan Bradley doesn't like me. That's a shame. Christopher Daniels, effective is good. That's right. It's just, I've got people I know that can train anybody really long, in-depth training, like military-style training, but that's not practical for about 95% of the population. Most people just need to defend themselves and carry a gun. If you're in a scenario where you're training to hide behind walls and engage targets and all this kind of stuff, you're kind of preparing for something that's more unrealistic than actually having to use your gun, which is already a very low probability. I do need a tactical pin. This is not a good tactical pin. This is just a normal little, like, thing. Ryan, what 12 gauge should I get? That's a good question. Hammer fire versus striker fire? Also a good question, Alex. Hammer fire and striker fire are both excellent guns. Choose which one's more comfortable to you and which one you like the versatility, because they're both going to go boom. So that's awesome. As far as a shotgun, I would go with either a Remington 870 or a Mossberg 500, both 12 gauge, which is amazing. Weekend Warriors. I guess you are not into James Yeager, which is probably a good thing. I am not into James Yeager. I have Glock pins. Yes, I do have Glock pins. Chuck Middleton, 870 Remington. That is true. You don't need to train for war, you need to train for a bump of the night. That's right. 357, good enough to defend yourself. Yes, it is. I'm 13 and people are surprised I can shoot a 45. Great. That's a lot of comments. Oh, man. I think I addressed all those. But yeah, so I train effectively. I train for worst case scenario. I don't train for Afghanistan, Iraq, or Fallujah. That's just not what I do. What Gen Glock do you like better? I like the 4s better. I like Gen 4s better. My brand new 870 got stolen, and it sucks. That does suck. My Glock got stolen, and that's wrong. I have Mossberg 500 Ducks Unlimited. My mom wanted a raffle. That's amazing. That's awesome. My favorite Glock Gen is Gen 4 because they have... Jonathan, stop that. I'm not doing a dab. No, that's not happening. Mm-mm. Nope. Have you ever had a CCW encounter where you had to pull your firearm out? No, because if I ever pull my firearm out, I'm shooting my firearm. That's the way I train people. That's the way that I hold myself. That is not a threat weapon. It is a defense weapon. If that gun comes out of my holster, it is going into deployment. And that's just kind of the way that I look at it. I'm not going to threaten somebody and escalate a situation. I'm going to end that situation. And I'm not trying to be a badass, because I don't think of myself as that way. But you need to be able to defend yourself. 5 to 7 years for brandishing, says Christopher Daniel. You can. You can get in trouble for that. Depends what state you're in. It depends the scenario. But thank God, man. I want to train with you now. Alex, I like it. I dig it. Where you at? I live in Georgia. I live in Atlanta, Georgia. Have you heard about the Marksman Challenge in South Dakota? No, I have not. Hey, dude, I picked up a Kiltec Sub 2000 at Academy Sports Gen 2 for $429. I heard that they are awesome. They're good guns. They're really fun. Yeah, Mason, I actually saw that come through my phone, and I was kind of like, wow, that was fast. I'm going to plug you guys in. Yeah, I'm not going to do it. Yeah, I don't keep guns in my car anymore, which is kind of sad. Oh, Mel asked, any lessons learned from having my gun stolen? Yeah, I don't keep my guns in my car. But one thing that someone just asked me that I want to try to address is the Glock 4th Gen versus 3rd Gen. The 4th Gen has a double spring on the inside underneath the barrel, and it also has more intense stippling on the grips, and it kind of bezeled the trigger a little bit, and those are three upgrades which I really like. Shooting a 40 and a 45 in a Gen 4 is completely different and much nicer than shooting it on a Gen 3. Just saying. ARs or AKs, they are both amazing guns, but I like ARs better because I'm, you know, American, that's our gun, and it's like Legos. What should I get for rabbits, a 22 or a pellet gun? Favorite, I can't even see that one. Love my Gen 423, that's because it's an amazing gun. That's actually the gun that got stolen from me. Is 300 Blackout good for hunting big game? How big? Like deer and pigs? Or like elk? How do you feel with the military going with SIG instead of Glock? Good or bad move? I think either way. They don't really train on pistols anyway. Glocks still have polymer guide rods. They do. Do they? Yeah, I think they do. I know there's a Gen 5 coming out though. If you're shooting elk, I'm not going to do 300 Blackout. I'm doing 308 or 30-06. Can I get a shout-out, please? Daniel Thomas! There's your shout-out. What I like best for groundhogs? 223 or 556? I missed that concealed carry one, sorry. Groundhogs, I do 556 with a precision AR-15, 20 to 24-inch barrel. Pretty good magnification scope, and just pop it. I was always told in the Marines that if it's good or a sidearm, something gone very wrong. Yeah, that's exactly what they say. That is exactly what they say. And Jonathan, getting the banhammer. First person I've ever gotten to banhammer. Boop. How old are you? I'm 31. I'm 31 years old. I just turned 31. I'm an old man. Trolls be trolls. Trolls do be trolls. Damn, that's big. I shoot 17 LR or 17 HR. That's good, too. Neptune says, yes, Glock still have polymer guide rods. Ooh, AC/DC came on. How long is this stream going to go? I don't know. Crazy. 12, I'm using a Winchester under overbreak. Nice. I'm going to roll in Dundas. 17 HMR is my go-to turtle slayer. That's true. That's very effective. Any shooting plans this week? New upcoming vids? Yes. Where those things go? All night, LOL. I don't think you go all night. In the Air Force, we had to use any weapons. Something's gone terribly wrong. Yeah, in the Air Force, they're like, let's hit this button. AC/DC, that's right. Yes, I do have videos upcoming. I just had these stupid things. Just had some patches. When you conceal carry, is it normal for you to be aware of your surroundings? I'm aware of my surroundings when I'm not concealed carrying. Always be aware of your surroundings. My friend let me use a $12,000 gun. Wow. Looking at Henry 22 mag pump, any thoughts? Henry's amazing. It's been hot here. I missed that last piece. 22 magnums are... No, 22 magnums. I'm sorry. Henry are extra excellent lever actions. Excellent. You can't really go wrong with them. And they're all made in America, which is cool. Like the... I think it's hickory, or it's walnut, chestnut, something like that. They're stocks. And... their barrels are made out of steel from Pennsylvania. They are awesome. I got 20% battery left on my phone because I've been doing this for an hour. Oh, man. Crazy. So cool. I love talking to you guys because I don't get the direct feedback before. I'm the person on planes that looks at every single move a Muslim does. I'm of the belief I don't care what you are, where you are, how you are. If you suspicious, you suspicious. I don't care what you are. I live in Atlanta, so I know a lot of people of multiple different ethnicities, and I'm kind of like, skirt. This is a very lively chat. It is a very lively chat. Cool, man. Good night. Love the channel. Keep it up. Thank you, Christopher Daniels. He's out to make sure they're not doing anything wrong. No, I get it. I get it. Just subbed to you not too long ago. Keep up the good work. Thank you, Ghost. And to whoever asked me if I'm making more videos, this week on Thursday, I'm going out to make 10 more videos. My mom died like a month ago. Could I shoot with you? Dude, don't do that to me. Daniel Thomas, I subscribed. Thank you, Daniel. If you were Taliban, get your head blown off. Come on, Mason. Let's not talk about these things in a gun channel. You'll get the feds in here. Good Lord. It's going downhill fast. What do you think about the Mossberg 702? It's a good gun. Mossberg's a good gun. You're cool, Mason. Oh, man. To be a kid. Dylan Carlisle. Howdy, fella. Partner. But yeah, I'm doing G2 stuff. They gave me these little patches. really cool. So I get to test these out. Show you guys what happens when these things shoot pig heads and stuff. And I'm thinking about doing fish, too. Sick patches. They are really cool patches. And my own Patreon. Awesome 10 more vids. Any hint to where you're going or shooting? Nope. Super secret location. Charge your phone. Bees, I can't go forever, man. I got like 3 kids who will be awake in like 6 hours. So, nope. Oh, man. That's awesome. I'm not on Patreon yet, but have you ever tried Dumb Dumb Rounds of Ballistic? No, I haven't. Look up Michelle Brown of Chelsea. I travel for work. Might have to sign up for training if I get an Atlanta errand. I would love that, Mel. That'd be amazing. Just send me an email and I'll be like, what? That's Mel the Nut. I'm a noob, so what's a G2? G2 is the company that makes the rip rounds. So these little things. 15 muzzle cooking bacon. Be interesting. But yeah, so GT Risk, what are your thoughts on the Savage Rifle Company? I don't have a lot of experience with them, honestly. I haven't heard bad or good, so not terrible. G2 makes the rip rounds. So these are the rounds that like split into like what's called trocars, and they kind of go like this, and they just like explode and cut like little spears. It's wicked crazy. And then they, wicked crazy. I've never said that in my life, and I said that on the internet. I bet rip rounds hurt. I bet they do too, but we're going to find out what they do. So the Civic Duty is like a different variety that they came out with. This was the first one, and then these two were next. So there's a Telios round. Daniel says, good night, love the channel, keep it up, bro. Thank you. Ryan Brown, just cooking bacon on my AK. That might not be good to eat. I want to be able to hit the side of a target. We can do that. Radically invasive projectiles, that's exactly right. What buckshot should we use for 20-gauge home defense? I would use birdshot the first few, and then I would use buckshot after that. I do not bow hunter or use archery because I have firearms. I want to do it, though, because it extends the season tremendously, and I'm kind of, like, tempted. Is it weird that I want to get shot in the shoulder? Yeah, it's weird to get shot in the shoulder, Mason. We're going down there, guys. This is, like, I think the hour mark is where it gets kind of like, whoo. Thank you, Neptune. The Civic Duty patch looks cool. You're awesome. Mason, I would not want to be shot with a 9mm ever. Trust me. I've seen some crazy stuff with a 9mm. All my tests. What do you think about a 338 Lapua Magnum? Amazing. That's what I think about a 338 Lapua Magnum. Do you fish at all? I do. I don't get to do as much anymore because my spare time is kind of taken up with the videos, which I love doing. It's fun. But I don't get to fish that much anymore. I was actually a fly fishing guide in Wyoming for a full summer when I was 20. And that's like the most beautiful country you'll ever see is Wyoming. Right around Jackson Hole area. Amazing. Whew, a lot of talking. Here I go again. Do ballistics brunch bacon on AR, fry eggs with Tannerite or something with toast. Okay. I like to see how a film. I missed it, I'm sorry. Is 40 good for home defense? Yes, it is. Gotta go. I'll be watching for the Patreon launch video. I will put that up, Mel. Thank you. Do you have a job? No offense. Yes, I do, Beast. Getting shot is not weird. It's just effed up. Okay. Shoot some Kevlar. That's been done like a million times, though. I don't really intrigue me. Interesting that two people asked me for Patreon stuff. That's interesting. All right, Asai is out of here. Says, crazy cool, thanks. I'm going to hit the hay. Good night. Mike E., good budget AR-10. It's not really a good budget AR-10. I know it sounds like I'm lying, but I'm 15 and it sucks. I've been 15. I was there like half my life ago. Oh, God. All right, bros. I'm going to call this at 65 minutes, which is a minute and a half. That's what I'm going to do. Because this is just getting cray-cray. I'm wasting no more time. So I have a question, Braden. It's a big one as well. What are your tips for someone wanting to get into competitive shooting? Competition shooting, I need help. Ryan Brown! He wanted a shout out, so I shouted him out. Competitive shooting, start... Well, it depends what kind. Neptune, I wish I was 15 too. Well, no, I don't. I wish I was 20. No, actually, I wish I was 30. 30 is the best. Mike says, keep up the good work. Thank you, Mike. Tannerite in front of Kevlar and see if it withstands the impact. That's a good idea. Why? Don't leave. Are you listening to channel or mix? I'm listening to Pandora. 80s music. Patreon is the only way now. YouTube doesn't cut it anymore. I agree, but I have an idea that's going to make that go away. And it's a better idea than Patreon. Videos on IDPA for beginners. Check it out. Ghost has he does have the IDPA videos. That might be good. Good night, brah. Nah, I'm too old. I don't know what that means. Do a 50 cal video. I will do that eventually. Good night, man. Alex is out. I will. Thank you, Alex. And guys, I am going to wind this little shindig down. But I thank you so much for watching. You guys are awesome. Huge shout out to me, please, and safe honoring the Second Amendment. Mason, my young guy in here, 12. My dream is about to shoot a Barrett. It's an awesome one. Ghost Tactical, thanks. Great show. Thank you, Ghost. Make sure you send me an email. I'd love to see what you've got going on there, and I'll see if I can help you in any way. Dave Port, see you next time. Later. Later. All right, boys. And girl. I don't discriminate. All right. Rifle I am in love with, long distance. I would do a 20 to 24-inch AR-15. All right, guys. I tell you what, Dylan. I'll give you one more minute. We got to finish that one. I would do a 20 to 24-inch barrel AR-15 if you want competition with a semi. And if you want competition with a bolt action, I would do a obviously a bolt action gun in either 30-06 or 308. That's what I would do. Later, Redneck. And I'm just waiting on Dylan, and then we should be good to go. Do stream tomorrow. I don't want to overdo the streams. That's the only thing. I might not. Later, Neptune. Good to see you from Switzerland. That's pretty cool. Thank you very much, man. No problem. Peace out, dude. How much kick does the 50 have versus the 12 gauge? That's the 50's nothing because they've engineered it that way. But until the next time, guys, I'm Braden. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.